armas hacia afuera, muchachos.
Hemos tomado ya 6 pueblos. Estamos apoyando hasta 3-4 días, mientras la gente solos se arman y empiezan a defenderse. No hay gobierno. Gobiernos trabajando junto con los criminales.
This OPPO scene happened on our fourth day in Mexico. So, you know, this was right at the beginning. We were still trying to figure out what we were getting ourselves into. And to me, I think this was still kind of one of my most memorable scenes in the film, at least for, you know, what we experienced. Because, you know, going into that situation, I mean, I'm not a war photographer. I have no desire to be a war photographer despite doing this film. And so for me, this scene kind of, I don't know, this is where I kind of understood the tension that was going on in Mexico, because this was still very early on. I mean, like you said, they had only taken 6 towns, and I think, you know, they kept doing this for almost another year after this.
Yo creo que la gente aquí, pues no, la verdad no los está solicitando. Yo no veo gente aquí.
Ustedes
con esas armas.
Si la gente no quiere que nos, si la gente dice que nos vayan, o nos vamos.
Sí, no, la gente le tiene miedo a usted.
No. Vaya y pregunte a todos los pueblos que hemos ido.
No, yo no tengo que por qué ir a preguntar.
Solo pensarme las cosas.
Neither Matt or I speak Spanish. And so, you know, we're in this environment, again, fourth day in Mexico. What was interesting is we didn't know exactly what was going on, but, you know, I think we were able to very easily understand what the mood was and you know, really distill it down to know what's going on. And I actually loved that, kind of being forced to respond to body language and respond to the way people wear their emotions on their face. As storytellers, our job is to go in and hopefully not have any preconceived notions of what the story is until we understand it for ourselves, is to go in and see it through their eyes. And so being able to just read their face and try to process that was an interesting way to shoot a film. I think we shot over 500 hours of footage, so we definitely had a lot to choose from. And I think the editors really made this film as they do most films. But again, you know, your goal is to go in and give them as much material as you can. So I think, you know, especially for as things like this started to mount, I found myself kind of having a checklist in my mind of running through, okay, make sure, you know, don't get caught up so much in the action that you don't pull back and get a wide and understand where we are and who's in the scene, or those kind of details. And so I've kind of found myself as both a way to just kind of stay calm and grounded, was to just have those checklists and make sure you get through them. But I mean, you know, this scene and so much of what was going on in Mexico, it's so visually stimulating and emotionally stimulating that anywhere you turn, there's something to be photographed and something to help tell that story. So it's just, you know, constantly staying focused and again, feel it for yourself. I mean, we're going through this story as much as the characters are. And so what are we seeing? What is, you know, making us respond to a scene that's just as worthy as shooting as what the other characters are seeing?